So this was the broad level of understanding as to how, what is happening in the IT industry, what kind of softwares are getting developed. Now we look at how the software is developed. What is the process? So anything which is developed from scratch has to follow some kind of a process. It cannot be ad hoc. Okay. So softwares are also developed following certain processes. There are a lot of processes, but before we get into a typical software development process and see more, we will try and simulate it with something which everyone is familiar with in India, so that you can get a sense of as to what happens in software development. So you might be aware of waterfall, as you mentioned. So it might be a slight repetition of things, but just let's go through it quickly. So in order to understand that, let's see, how do we construct a house? So let's say you want to build an independent house in a city in India. Okay. How do we go through this process? What happens exactly? So obviously it will start with the conceptualization. So the owner of the house, who is going to make it, will have some kind of an idea as to, okay, this is the way my house should look like. Okay. Whether it's a tiled roof or it's a flat roof, there's a big garden in front of it, there's a swimming pool, whatever it is, there is a vision for the owner. That's how it starts. But since the owner may not be the right person to build a house, they will hire a contractor or the specialist. So when the contractor comes into picture, there must be some kind of an agreement which needs to be signed with the contractor. Okay. Maybe time frame, maybe budget or whatever. In order to do that, the contractor will try and understand what exactly do you need. Okay. So in that case, you will explain to the contractor as to what is my vision of the things. Obviously, you are not an architect, nor you are a civil engineer. So typically what we'll do, you'll do a rough sketch the way you want things to be and then give it to the contractor. It's up to the contractor to understand. So it's always be a rough sketch of the things which you want, or you may explain it orally to the contractor. With this information, the contractor has to give it a shape. Without giving it a shape, it can never work out in any scenario. So contractors also use some kind of visual representation of the house to show it to you, so that he or she gets an understanding as to what is your actual vision. So they create something like perspective in building a design, building a house. And there are multiple views of the same thing. So from the back side, from the front side, from the sides, so that you get a clear picture as to how the house would look like. Once this broad level understanding is kind of agreed by the customer, then he will start going into the details of it as to how the floors will look like. What is the floor plan? Something like this. There the detailing will be to the minutest details. The size, the dimensions, the width of the walls, even where will be the WC, where will be the kitchen, where will be the bedroom, everything, how the doors will open. All of these detailing will be then done by the contractor. Again, after the contractor is done with the design, he will come to you and the customer or you have to approve it, saying that yes, this is now what I feel I am looking at, and then the construction will start. So obviously construction will be monitored by the contractor because they are the specialist. You don't understand how many rods to be put in, what is the foundation level, you don't understand that. So they will start working on building the house. During the construction, the contractor will keep on verifying at every stage, so that there is not a major deviation from the planned model of the house. That's a regular thing which has to happen. It's a quality check or the progress check, whatever we may call it. Once the house is ready, the contractor will do a final check, saying that, okay, fine, this is what was the plan and this is what the house is. It looks like okay to me. And then after the finishing touches and all, it will be given to you or the customer for approval. So customer will then come and see whatever is there before saying, okay, fine, it's done. Final payment is made to the contractor. This is how the house construction typically happens if you are going to make an independent house for yourself. Now, why did we learn this? That is because software development process is absolutely similar to what you have just learned. Okay. In fact, when the software development process was being conceptualized, there were a couple of industries from which the inspiration has been taken. One is the manufacturing, because the software development started somewhere around late 1950s and early 60s. At that point in time, there were two mature industries. One was the manufacturing, auto manufacturing and other manufacturing industries, and the civil construction industry. These are the only two industries which are mature. So the entire inspiration for developing software was taken from that only. So what we are going to discuss is the initial early stage of software development processes, which is also known as now waterfall. Okay. As we go along in the course, we are going to see a lot many other processes, and we'll see how things have evolved over the last 30, 40 years. So let's start and try and map it to our software development. So the first step was the visualization of the house. So very similar to that, a customer will think of a software saying that I need to automate my business process. I need to automate my financial accounting system. I need to automate my billing system. So there will be a conceptualization or thought of developing a software. That was the first step in the construction of the house as well. What was the next step? The customer hires a contractor for developing it. In the same manner, the customer will hire an IT company or a software company to develop the software. Now, once you have hired a vendor, in a house construction case, once you have hired a contractor, you need to convey to the contractor, both civil contractor or the IT company, as to what is your need or what is your requirement. That process or that phase where you are explaining the requirements to the IT vendor or IT vendor is trying to understand what do you need is known as requirement gathering phase of software development. And that is the most important phase where business analysts play the most critical role. It's purely dependent on business analyst as far as the success of the project is concerned. Once the requirement has been, or once you start gathering the requirements, then to understand it better, there has to be some kind of modeling or the physical representation to the requirements. By just saying that I need a screen where people can come and search for a product and then look at it details and then go and buy, make a decision to buy it, is not going to help in developing a software. There has to be some physical format which must be created so that customer sees what he is going to get and the technical team understands what is to be developed. That is called a modeling, or that is called modeling in software parlance as well. Modeling is a standard term. It's everywhere the same. Name is the same. And this phase is known as requirement analysis and modeling. This is an iterative phase where some back and forth happens with the customer. Once the requirement analysis and modeling is done, then more detailing is created. So in this case, it's a detailed flow plan and other elevations and other stuff. In software, this is called design. This is the place where business analysts stop interacting or stop getting directly involved in the project. Business analyst role stops at the requirement analysis, modeling, and the requirements document finalization. After that, they will only be required if the technical team, which is doing the design, needs their input, if they need some clarifications, or if there is something which is mentioned in the requirements document or specs which they are not able to understand. Then only they will contact the business analyst, who will then give them the inputs. Then, as in the case of constructing a house, the contractor will seek an approval from you, saying that now everything is done, now please approve it so that I can start making it. Similarly, here there is a sign off phase. So everything is done, detailed design, model is done, analysis is done, customer is happy, business analyst is satisfied. So now there is a go ahead. And then construction starts. In the software case, coding starts. Okay, that is the programming part of it, where developers will get involved. During this entire process of coding, a lot of verification happens, just like the contractor does the verification during the construction of the house. There's absolutely no difference. To make sure that things don't deviate too much from the agreed requirements, verifications and testing have to happen at regular intervals. Once the house is ready, the contractor verifies the house as per the plan. Similarly, in this case, somebody has to verify the final product, which is known as final round of testing or functional testing. This is again where business analysts play an important role, because they know what is expected. So they only are responsible for this final round of testing, known as system testing, known as functional testing. Various names are given to them. Finally, as in the case of building, the house is given to the customer for test checking whether everything is okay. Here also, the software is given to the customer for making sure that they are happy with it. That is called acceptance testing, or UAT, user acceptance testing. Various names given to it. Okay, customer says okay, everything is fine, then you go ahead and they start using it, which is known as go live. That's a phase. If they are not happy with it, that means there are defects which has to be fixed by the development team. So there could be a back and forth. So typically UATs are given some period of time, maybe 3 weeks, 4 weeks of time, during which some back and forth happens. There could be some problems with the software, which the technical team will solve and then give it back to the customer for test. So that's a typical software development life cycle. This is the place where something is developed from scratch.